What is up, YouTube? Epic Gamer 0408 here with another YouTube video. And my preseason was pretty well, went 3-1, so let's see. Hopefully we don't blow a 3-1 lead like the Warriors. Ha. Wasn't that funny? But anyway, like I was saying, yeah. So let's see if we can do good. So this game is up against the Chiefs. Let's go.
King, like I'm from Akron. I'm going overboard. Somebody call the captain. And when it comes to getting checks, I always want the fat ones. I'm so I can sing to a chandelier. My flow a glass of spade and yours a can of candle.
Too many buttons. Not enough. These fucking the SWAT is coming. Shoulder, no shoulder, shrugging at your nugget. Sticky like acupuncture and Magnus honey. Knock on the side door 3 times and have your money. Or get to stepping like Kappa stomping. I slap. I'm having lunch with Italian Sonny. Don't ask the subject. Lord, why you took rabbit from me? He say don't ask me nothing. Too many bodies, too many bundles. Not enough. These bugging, I heard they stun you. It's gonna be trouble. We come through and catch you while you cuddle. Barrels like tunnels. Don't even mumble.
I'm back to balling. I'm in the back full of only. The scene in the queen playing past Detroit. Ready turkey spaghetti and castor oil. That's turn your guillotine to a fashion show. In 4 minutes, I turn this into forensics in a foreign car with a foreign. It's long-winded, paper long, and you taking long. You just don't get it. Run the phone up on Satan, he want a song with me. Hotter than Mississippi, the summer of the 1950s. In a van full of some white. Get pulled over for swerving like high officer. When he asked me why I was swerving, I'm officer.
I can make it bounce by myself. I can make it bounce by myself. I can make it bounce by myself. I can make it bounce by myself.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Rootley. You're tuned in to the NFL on EA Sports.
Larry, from one of the loudest venues in the NFL, there's a look at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. Tonight, it's the Thursday opener for the new NFL season between the London Monarchs and the Kansas City Chiefs. This is taken at his 4. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. So here come the Chiefs for their opening drive. They'll be led out by the number 1 overall selection back in 05 out of the University of Utah. It's Alex Smith.
I think one of the things that attracted people to Alex Smith initially was his mobility, and that's never changed. That guy's a great athlete, but he's so sharp with the football, so accurate, and takes care of it so well, he rarely puts his team in bad situations.
They go play action here on first down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. It'll be a loss of 10, and it'll bring up second.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Thomas Rawls with his first carry. And some room to roam now. A very solid gain of 27.
I love football lingo and the evolution of it all. Nickel defense. Makes sense, right? Five defensive backs. But then you go to six. What are you going to call that? And they call it a
double
dime.
It.
A dime, which is just very simple for them. The math doesn't add up. But I know one thing. Offenses love to run against dime defenses. Typically, the bigger guys have an advantage against the smaller defensive backs when they're blocking downfield.
Yeah, we saw that advantage right there. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Second down following the run.
Oh, man, that wasn't far from breaking in a big way into the secondary. Read option, quarterback kept it. And while he didn't get a first down, he did get a nice chunk of yardage. Only a nice tackle prevented it from maybe going all the way.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a third and three. They brought in an extra defensive back here, so probably not expecting a run on third and three.
A good call.
This is Rawls, and he is going to lose yardage here. He lost two, and it brings up fourth.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner, and the tackler was there right away for a loss of yardage.
This one will sail out of bounds. It'll depend on the spot here. And the side judge says that went out at the 7-yard line. Very tough spot here for the offense to start. Brown, the lone receiver left. To throw is Brissett. Out to his left. Gronkowski's got it on the crossing route. And they're going to have this one up near the 30-yard line. The play fake. Here's Brissett. And he's got his big tight end over the middle, complete. A good pick up there of 20 yards. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Freeman again, fighting through, and now they're going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down. On play action, Brissett on the move to his left. He can run for it, and he will, and avoids the contact by sliding. They give him 7 yards on the play, and they do pick up the conversion on third down. Play fake, Brissett. Goes right side, complete to Gronk. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. It'll be a gain of six, and it's a second down. They go play action with Brissett, rolling to his left. And some space here. And he slides to avoid the hit. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move
flex
the sticks.
Round. Flex round. Flex round. Let's go.
On first and 10, Brissett flush to his right. And complete on the right side to Bennett. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. So a loss of five, and it'll be second down. Play action now. Brissett steps away. This is caught. Gronkowski. And he's into the end zone for the receiving touchdown. Rob Gronkowski, 28 yards. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead. Oh, it's a fake. They'll try and throw for it. Quarterback loves the receivers, but sometimes his best friend is that tight end.
Yeah, it's hard to believe, isn't it? Because we always talk about the guys out wide and how acrobatic they are. But that tight end, great sight lines, easier throws. They become a bigger and bigger weapon as the NFL evolves.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be taken short. And they're going to have really good starting field position here as that's taken up close to the 40. Out now the Chiefs offensive unit ready to do battle again. And they'll be looking to avoid what happened last time, which is punting the football.
Cover!
But when you look at how teams play the game, that complementary football comes into play. How do I take care of my defense? How do I take care of my offense? Well, the defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways. Now it's time for the offense to jump things up and help their defense out. Give them a little bit of rest.
Yeah, time for them to give them a rest. You took the words right out of my mouth. Here's Smith now on second down. And Hill with it over the middle. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. As the Chiefs in possession of the football as we begin the second quarter. They'll face a third down conversion attempt here, 3rd and 3. They come up in an offset eye. Smith on 3rd down. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Cameron Jordan able to get him down for a loss of 11 on the play. And it'll be 4th down. Here's Dustin Colquitt now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. And now a high kick here as he'll try to hang it up there. Fair catch signaled for and taken just shy of the 30-yard line. They'll call that a 33-yard punt with no return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
If you love pressure,
we'll
see if they dial it up this drive. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. They'll try to throw now. Brissett hit as he throws there. Incomplete. Unable to get it to Gronkowski that time. And it's 3rd and 4.
It's always tough trying to keep your guy upright when he's trying to throw the football. When you're dealing with those big, bad guys on the defensive front, it's even tougher. And this time, those guys on the opposite side won the battle, getting to the quarterback and knocking him into an incompletion.
He may try and run for this. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. Fresh set of downs here. Brissett on 1st down. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
One of the great coaches said football is a really simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
Here we go. 1-9. 1-9.
On 3rd down, Brissett throws left side, complete to Brandon Marshall. They stop him for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up 4th down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not.
And look at this. It's a fake. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. Well, not only did they try to fake it, they put the ball in the arm of their punter, and it didn't work out.
Not the quarterback.
No.
The punter.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Risky.
It is so funny because when it works, genius. When it doesn't work, not so smart.
Not so genius.
In this case, not so genius, but I do admire that he went for it.
Reggie Nelson, the free safety, in on the stop. And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here. They stay on the ground. Rolls again. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And that'll make it. They've got an extra defensive back out there now on third and 13. They'll fake the handoff. Now Smith. And he'll be hit from behind and taken down. Von Miller with a big-time sack on third down. And it'll be a loss of 7. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Arrowhead after this. A reminder coming up at this and every halftime this season, we'll be checking in with Larry Ridley in Orlando for highlights and analysis of our first half.
LR, that's my man.
That's your guy. Just 34 yards on the punt there, no return. And the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. Now this offense ready to take over again. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond. Yeah. Antonio Brown, kiss him goodbye. Touchdown! Antonio Brown, 71 yards. And his guys get the quick strike touchdown. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. And last drive, 3 and out. Still a goose egg on the scoreboard. How do they break that goose egg?
They've got to find a way to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, get them some space, and try and make a first down and get some momentum going. It's been a struggle for them throughout the game, and that 3 and out on the last possession, that told you just how stalled they are on offense.
So who will step up here? We'll see. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. And just a simple, basic neutral zone infraction here, partner.
Yeah, when you're ready to launch and go get the quarterback, sometimes you take off a bit too fast.
On second down, here's Smith. Trying to fight his tight end, Kelsey, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. And now back out comes the offense. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here. To throw, Brissett, flushed out right. And he's got room. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
Here's Brissett. He finds Marshall on the screen. And eventually brought down, but it's near the 5 at the 6. From the gun, here's Brissett, eluding the pressure right.
Heard a coach talk about those late-in-the-half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion this half. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And we get a glance at this defense again. And the interception, the last time they were out there, ended up leading to a touchdown.
So the only thing they didn't get really was the pick six, because that's what everyone wants. Take it immediately to the end zone, but their offense capitalized.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Here's Smith now on second down. Going to Rawls on the dump off. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Now a play fake here on first down. He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's... There he goes, right side. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Well, partner, I do know this. If you're a defensive back, you have more chances to make a team now than ever because people are using five defensive backs, six defensive back packages. Not exclusively, but way more than before. That was a nickel package there, and what a pickoff.
Why is that? Why are they using that more?
Because more people are throwing the ball on earlier downs than ever before. This has become a passing league, and because of that, more defensive backs on the field on most plays.
That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
Second down, Rawls. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. So we have reached halftime. Jeez, they don't even want to let their guys get a drink of water. All right, third quarter, let's get to it. So here they come, the road team now getting the football first to start this third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Now Brissett, dancing to his left. Oh, he's got a little daylight. He can't bring him down.
The weight room does work.
It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he rifles one incomplete. Trying to get that in the hands of Devontae Freeman that time. And it's third and short. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
Here's Marquette King now. as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. And they're going to try this again. It's another fake. He's got a man. It's his fullback. And the fake will work. He's going to have a first down. Well, there's a new man here under center. What do you think they saw to acquire him, Charles?
I think they went back to their old scouting reports because those never go away. And I think that they liked him when he was coming out of school, didn't have the opportunity to get him. But now with this opportunity, they think they can get him back to his former level.
It's complete to Brown, right side. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 12 yards on the pickup, and it'll give him the first down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. They go play action here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
Let's go!
Play fake. Brissett. Deep drop. His throw caught right around the 6. And he gets into the end zone for the touchdown. Martellus Bennett, 34 yards. And this offense is running away with this one.
The tight end can kind of be that diamond in the rough secret weapon that you have, and right there they show you why.
And it's becoming less of a secret, isn't it, partner? Every game that we do nowadays, the tight end is a featured receiver, not just a blocker, as in the days of old.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. It's a very short kick taken by an up man. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. So here's the Chiefs offense ready for their first reps in half number 2. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter 3.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. We can go inside the locker room, right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out if that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
We just saw another example of how the defense is winning this game. Really at the point of attack, the offensive line's just getting pushed around. I think now as a play caller, you've got to give them a little bit of help. Maybe keep your tight ends a little bit more. Maybe the running backs help you a little bit with the pass blocking. But you've got to help them get some confidence because you can't abandon the play calling right now. You know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away, but could not.
Brandon, sometimes I think when we watch games, we're actually watching a living museum because we're seeing the evolution of positions almost with each passing game. How about defensive ends nowadays and the way that they can run almost all the way across the field?
It is unbelievable, isn't it? I mean, they're so strong, but they're so lean, they can move so quick with those bodies.
It's almost unfair. You're supposed to be able to know where a defensive end is supposed to be on every play. These guys flash so quickly, you're not sure where they're going to end up.
All things considered, a pretty good kick. Just cruel punishment there to be denied by the crossbar.
If you're going to hit from that distance, sometimes you're going to need a little luck. And unfortunately for him, this time the break goes against him.
Gronkowski got it on the crossing route. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. And quickly, they get to the line.
Here we go.
First down, Brissett. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
On play action, Brissett sliding out of the pocket. And this is caught at the 8. And he will take it in for the touchdown. Malcolm Mitchell, 33 yards. And this offense continues to pour it on.
Brandon, is there any...
Oh, this is blocked. Now it's scooped up, and this is a through an opening, and there he goes. He's at the 30. And all the way in
into the end zone, and it's 2 points. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be taken very short. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And the last go-around for them, they tried that really, really long field goal, couldn't connect.
And in retrospect, I think a lot of people would say, well, why would you try one that long? You hurt yourself in field position, the ball comes out, you know, there. That only helps the other team. But I look at it as maybe it was a double shot of confidence. Confident the kicker could make it, and even if he missed, confident in their defense that they could hold him. Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
We're back now in KC. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. On first down, Smith. And they can't get the long connection as it falls incomplete. His favorite target, Travis Kelce, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down. On second and 10, Smith surveying the field. And his throw here is incomplete. Jeremy Maclin, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
Throwing on third down, Smith. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 46. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Yeah, and that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's a really difficult task.
That'll go as a punt of 32 yards. And here now the offense heading back out there. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Now a play fake here on first down. Over the middle here to Brown. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40.
And they just had another big completion there. And I think in days gone by in the NFL, you might have asked, is this a little bit of overkill? Is this rubbing it in? I don't think people feel the same way nowadays.
The age-old argument. Then you could say on the other side, if you're going to get angry about it, stop it, right?
Go ahead and stop me. And I think a lot of the times they just look at it like, let's just play the game. And however it turns out, it turns out. I know they don't like to hear it when they get to a certain age. But then you have to start to use your skills, your wiles, right? Your mind to beat guys to the football. And getting your toes tapped in bounds definitely qualifies as that, doesn't it?
The veteran showing he still has the agility. And now they're in the hurry up. Freeman again, a first down carry. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
Let's go!
From the red zone now, Brissett. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Devontae Freeman from 17 yards out. And this offense is running away with this one.
And now we've hit that stage of the game, partner, where one of our predecessors, one of the great commentators of all time, He's to sing in this situation when this game appeared to be over.
I know the fat lady's been singing for some time.
No, not her at all. This
but
one of
she's
our guys.
Singing too.
Oh, she's singing. She, yeah,
she's
at least,
on like the fifth tune. At
yeah,
this point.
She left scales way behind. But he's to sing something about turning out the lights. The party was over.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I can tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut it. All right? So you got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
On first and 10, Smith. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Now a first down throw. It's Smith. To the right side, it's Kelsey. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think they were looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. He's got size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here.
Well, you're trailing. It's the fourth quarter, and you've got to throw the football. But the defense knows this, too. So they're just going to sit back, bring in an extra defensive back or two, the old nickel or dime strategy, Brandon, and wait for you to put that bad boy up for grabs. And this one winds up being intercepted.
First down, Brissett. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Allen Bailey in there to get him for his second sack of the night. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo.
Let's go!
Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. So it's our visitors with a football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On second down, Freeman. And the most curious way there to burn some clock. That was wild. And at the end of all that, it winds up a safety. All right, Charles, help me out here. Fourth quarter, you've got the lead, and you run backwards into the end zone. You're just trying to do too much.
I almost don't have words for it, but you know every coach that we talk to talks about running backs or people running the football, running north-south, getting upfield. He went way in the opposite direction, and that's going to cost his team.
Yeah, it cost him big time. Still leading, but it cost him. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward. That was a nicely run slant route. And what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Desperation time for Smith on fourth down. And this is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the ball will go over on down downs on the short side of the field. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. They come into enemy territory, and I don't care what the matchup is in the National Football League. You're up like this late in the game on the road. This feels pretty good.
Oh, it feels fantastic. Anytime you get a road victory in the NFL, that's a big-time accomplishment. And to do it this convincingly, that just tears up the script that every home team has, which is nobody comes into our house and pushes us around. They took care of business today.
Yeah, they pushed around, and now the final stages of this one. And an extra DB here for the Chiefs on third down.
Pass situation.
Flip, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. Fourth down, Brissett. He shakes it off. A hit as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. A gutsy call by Jack Del Rio, but it does not pay off. And the Chiefs defense comes up with a stop. The Chiefs offense now making their way back onto the field. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
Going forward.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it, because
you're not going to want that feeling.
No, you don't want that.